As you wish. As you wish. As you wish.
Maybe you could come over and read it again to me tomorrow.
As you wish.
In the movie The Princess Bride, the importance of masculine dominance and control are constructed through interactions with both female and male characters. Throughout the movie, this is displayed in three categories: the damsel in distress, femininity in male characters, and the body language in male characters.
In this first clip, we see Buttercup taking on the damsel in distress role. When her dress gets lit on fire, we see her not taking action to put it out. Her first reaction to the fire is to scream and grab for Wesley. This displays that female characters cannot take care of themselves and they have to have a man to help them out in any situation. Usually the male characters are the ones that take control. We are going to continue this clip to show how Buttercup relies on Wesley for protection. In this scene, once again, we see Buttercup rely on Wesley for her own safety. She's not paying attention to the dangers around her because she's very well aware that Wesley is going to take care of her and he's going to be aware of the dangers for her.
Oftentimes, when the damsel in distress takes their own path, they need to be safe from the dangers they encounter. As we see here, when Buttercup led the way, she fell into the sand pit. Wesley does not second guess about saving her. He has accepted the fact that Buttercup needs to be saved. When getting pulled out of the sand, Buttercup is hanging on to Wesley, fully relying on him to save her. This confirms our point of a damsel in distress by always needing a rescuer.
In the study done by England, Descartes, and Kohler Meek, they observed the traditionally masculine and traditionally feminine characteristics exhibited by the prince and princess characters through their behaviors and actions. When they looked at the princess's feminine characteristics, they saw a repeating pattern. They were portrayed as physically weak, submissive, showing emotion, affectionate, nurturing, troublesome, fearful, and collapsing crying, to name a few. In this chart that we see, it shows how many times the princess character displays feminine traits in comparison to the masculine traits they display. Looking at the movie Snow White, we see 137 times that she acted feminine, and it acted masculine only 13 times. This supports the point that female characters in movies are portrayed as the stereotypical woman.
For the third time, Buttercup does not take action to protect herself or help Wesley when he's struggling. When she sees the rat come towards her, the first reaction she has is to scream for Wesley to protect her. Although Buttercup has a lock to defend herself, she's portrayed as if she doesn't know how to use it.
In the past three scenes with the damsel in distress, there are oftentimes as a hero, which is usually portrayed by the male lead role. However, male characters don't always have to have male characteristics. Sometimes their feminine traits come out as well. Coding of masculinity tended to be addressed in conjunction with complementary representations of femininity.
I do not suppose you could have speed things up.
I'm afraid you'll just have to wait.
Is there any way you'll trust me?
Nothing comes to mind.
I swear on the soul of my father, Domingo Montoya, you will reach the top alive.
Throw me the rope.
Wesley's showing feminine traits by asking for help and accepting it, not only up the cliff, but for the time to rest before they start fighting. The stereotypical male would not accept this help from other person because they need to show that they are strong and masculine.
Well, wait until you're ready.
Again, thank you.
Fezzik and Inigo were reunited. And as Fezzik nursed his inebriated friend back to health, he told Inigo of Vizzini's death and the existence of Count Rugen, the six-fingered man. Considering Inigo's lifelong search, he handled the news surprisingly well. Fezzik took great care in reviving Inigo.
That's enough! That's enough!
Typically, men do not have caring or nurturing characteristics, and in this case, the giant has both. The giant is confident in helping his inebriated friend Inigo because he's portrayed as having the ideal masculine figure. Having some feminine traits come from him is okay because the audience is well aware that the giant is already very, very masculine. These roles have been exposed to us since we were children.
She doesn't get eaten by the eels at this time.
What?
The eel doesn't get her. I'm explaining to you because you look nervous.
I was nervous. Well, maybe I was a little bit concerned, but that's not the same thing.
Because we can stop now if you want.
No, you could read a little bit more if you want.
As we see in this scene, the grandson is afraid but does not want to show his fear. But his facial expression and the clenching of the blanket gives that away. By the grandson saying he is concerned, he is trying to compensate for showing a feminine trait of fear. It is more acceptable for a male to be concerned than afraid. At this young age, children already know what gender stereotype they fall into and try to act accordingly.
A number of tropes commonly used to construct viral masculinity, including a level or upward assertive gaze. The body is muscular, active and tout rather than passive, and the portrayal of men of color and working class coded men as hypermasculine.
I have loved more deeply than a killer like yourself could ever dream.
That was a warning, Highness. The next time my hand flies on its own, for where I come from, there are penalties when a woman lies.
Men show their dominance through their physical actions. As we see here, Wesley controls the princess by the raising of his hand, which is an example of his physical strength. This interaction between the prince and the princess supports our thesis of masculine dominance because as Wesley gives his demands, the princess listens.
Men are stereotypically portrayed as muscular and active. The giant is that stereotypical male in The Princess Bride. As he pulls himself and three others up the cliff, he displays his strength. When the giant is doing this task, he makes it seem as it takes no effort. This gives off the impression that to be a male, you need to be strong.
For working class males who have less access to more abstract forms of masculinity validating power, such as economic power, workplace authority, the physical body and its potential for violence provided concrete means of achieving and asserting manhood. Both Wesley and the giant relate to what Katz was saying. Wesley was a farm boy and the giant had an assortment of random jobs. Both used their physical strength and bodies to achieve their goals. Wesley takes on the protective role to ensure Buttercup is safe. It is instinct for him to draw his sword and place Buttercup behind him when he hears the horses. These actions replicate what a stereotypical male would do. This shows the audience that males will put their lives at risk to save loved ones and that they should not have fear to do so.
The Princess Bride displays male dominance through the interactions with male and female characters. In each group, we're reminded of the stereotypes that are still present in our society. This is just one movie of many that portrays male dominance in films. With that being said, this concludes our analysis of male dominance and control in The Princess Bride.